Guys, welcome back to another episode of the Guys Book Club in the Board. Thank you, Book Club. Yeah. And today, guys, we're on an extreme, extreme, extreme special episode because today, guys, we're on episode 166. You know what it means? It means that it's going to be only one episode, only 166 episode. It's not going to be any more like this or less than this. Only one time I'm going to record episode 166, guys. And it's really exciting, guys. And guys, if you're new to the channel, welcome. And if you're already familiar with the channel, welcome back. My name is Ekan Dandros. And on this podcast, we are working together on an English speaking level, amazing level, and the communication skills to stand in front of the camera and to communicate well through the camera. And doing so because I truly, 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 truly believe that English is the number one tool each one of us must acquire in order to be successful in life. And the second tool that is going to help us a lot is to know how to communicate well through the camera and to know how to make great content for this easy device in English. Because if you know how to make great content for social media, you're going to be the king and queen of this area. And you can communicate with billions of people around the world and can influence billions of people around the world. So I recommend you to work on those skills. And if you can see today, we are going to play some soccer or football, depending on where you are from the world. I don't play soccer, but I watch the Euro and I enjoy it. And if you want to check out this great background, you can find it, you know, where 3, 2, 1, goddamn. You can find it on Good Fun. And this great background was uploaded to Good Fun by Default Fate, I think, on 18 of November 2017. And guys, as I told you already, as you already know, let's see, it's a little nice. Yeah. You can adjust that if you want to choose a resolution, you just need to press on this button over here. Choose the resolution that you want, press download, double click. Right click, Shmat Manu Shem or set picture S. Choose the location that you want to choose it. Press save over here and kabam, just like that, you got this full resolution of the picture. And of course, guys, we have one to do this great background. And today, guys, we'll continue our journey with the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen R. Covey. Really nice book, really great book, a lot of nice ideas. And if you want to check out the book, Stephen R. Covey, all this great background, you can get all the links in the description below. And guys, if you love the video or the podcast, please let me know in the comment below if something is useful you learned. And please, if you love it, please like the video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel, and put the notification bell so you'll be notified when each time and it's exciting, extremely exciting to upload to YouTube. Thank you very much. It's going to help me a lot. And without any more introduction, let's just dive right into the book. Back to the book. So the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen R. Covey, page 111. Read by the meat, the legend, the one and the many seven uses, please. Your boy, AK, what's up, that's me, let's go. You're guided by hours of evaluate your actions in the context of church teaching and expectation. Wisdom. You see the world in terms of believers and non-believers, belongers and non-belongers. Problem. Perceived power come from your charge, your position, or role. If you're self-centered, security. Your security is constantly changing and shifting. Guidance. Your judgment criteria are if it feels good, what I want, what I need, what's in it for me. Wisdom. You will be governed by how decisions, when events or circumstances will affect you. Power. Your ability to act is limited to your own resources. Without the benefits of interdependency. More often than not, a person's center is some combination of those and or the other centers. Most people are very much a function of a variety of influences that play upon their lives. Depending on external or internal conditions, one particular center might be activated until the underlying needs are satisfied. Then another center becomes the compelling force. Et cette personne flock to its heads from one sentence to another. The resulting relativism is like roller coasting for life. One moment you are high, the next moment you are low. Make an effort to compensate for one weakness by borrowing strength from another weakness. There is no consistent sense of direction, no persistent wisdom, no steady power supply, or sense of personal intrinsic growth and identity. The ideal, of course, is to create a one clear center from which you constantly derive a high degree of security, guidance, wisdom, and power, empowering your productivity and giving a congruency and harmony to every part of your life. A principal center. By centering our lives on correct principles, we create a solid foundation for development of the four life support factors. Our security comes from knowing that, unlike other centers, based on people or things which are subject to frequent and immediate change, correct principles do not change. We can depend on them. Principles don't react to anything. They won't divorce us or run away with our best friend. They aren't out to get us. They can't pave our way with shortcuts and quick fixes. They don't depend on the behavior of others, the environment, or the current Fed for the validity. Principles don't die. They aren't here one day and gone the next. They can be destroyed by fire, earthquake, or death. Principles are deep fundamental truths, classic truths, generating common denominators. They are tightly interwoven, threads running with exactness, consistency, beauty, and strength for the fabric of life. Even in the midst of people or circumstances that seem to ignore the principles, we can be secure in the knowledge that the principles are bigger than people or circumstances, and that thousands of years of history have seen them triumph time and time again. Even more important, we can be secure in the knowledge that we can validate them in our own lives, by our own experience. Admittedly, we are not omniscient. Our knowledge and understanding of correct principles is limited by our own lack of awareness of our true nature and the world around us, by the flood of trendy philosophies and theories that are not in harmony with correct principles. Those ideas will have their season of acceptance. But like many before them, they won't endure because they are built on false foundations. We are limited, but we can push back the borders of our limitations. An understanding of the principle of our own growth enables us to search out correct principles with the confidence that the more we learn, the more clearly we can focus the lens from which we see the world. The principles don't change. Our understanding of them does. The wisdom and the guidance that accompany principle centers living in come from correct maps, from the way things really are, have been, and will be. Correct maps enables us to clearly see where we want to go and how to get there. We can make our decisions using the correct data that will make the implementation possible and meaningful. The personal power that comes from a principle-centered living is the power of a self-aware, knowledgeable, proactive individual understricted by the attitudes, behaviors, and actions of others, or by many of the circumstances and mental influences that limit other people. The only real limitation of power is the natural consequences of the principles themselves. We are free to choose our actions based on our knowledge of correct principles, but we are not free to choose the consequences of those actions. Remember, if you pick up one end of the stick, you pick up the other. Principles always have natural consequences attached to them. There are positive consequences when we live in harmony with the principle, with the principles. There are negative consequences when we ignore them. But because those principles apply to everyone, whether or not they are aware, this limitation is universal. And the more we know of correct principles, the greater is our personal freedom to act wisely. By centering our lives on timeless, unchanging principles, we create a fundamental paradigm of effective living. It is the center that puts all other centers in perspective. If you are principle-centered, title, security. Your security is based on correct principles that do not change regardless of external conditions or circumstances. You know that true principles can repeatedly be validated in your own life, through your own experiences. As a measurement of self-improvement, correct principles function with exactness, consistency, beauty, and strength. Correct principles help you understand your own development, endowing you with the confidence to learn more, thereby increasing your knowledge and understanding. Your source of security provides you with an immovable, unchanging, unfailing core, enabling you to see change as an exciting adventure and opportunity to make a significant contributions. Guidance. You are guided by a compass which enables you to see where you want to go and how you will get there. You see accurate data which makes your decisions both implementable and meaningful. You stand apart from life's situations and circumstances and look as a balanced whole. Your decisions and actions reflect both short and long-term considerations and implications. In every situation, you consciously, proactively determine the best alternative, basing decisions. Unconsciously educated by principles. Wisdom. Your judgment encompasses a broad spectrum of long-term consequences and reflects a vast balance and a quiet assurance. You see things differently and those you think and act differently from the largely reactive world. You view the world for a fundamental paradigm for effective, provident living. You see the world in terms of what you can do for the world and its people. You adopt a proactive lifestyle, seeking to serve and build others. You interpret all the life's experiences in terms of opportunities for learning and contribution. However, your power is limited only by your understanding and observance of natural law and correct principles and by the natural consequences of the principles themselves. Guys, so guess what? This was the end of the episode. So guys, don't worry. This, as you see, it's episode 166. And today it's Sunday, which means you're going to get another 4 more exciting episodes this week. So yeah. Let's go. So guys, thank you much for joining me for this episode. I really appreciate the fact that you choose to invest your time with me. So shout out to you guys. Thank you very much. And guys, so guys, go on. I hope that this episode inspires you guys, and to go out and inspire the world, make a difference because you are sharing your message. Because the message to you, ladies and gentlemen, that are watching this little device, this camera from the camera, you are matter, and your message is it matter, and you can. There's only one you. You're unique, and you have a unique story to tell. So share it with the world, guys, Ladies and gentlemen, and expand the board. Since these guys go out and expand the board, have a great time with your family, friends, and neighbors. And if you guys are called about surrounding, please stay strong, stay safe until this coronavirus is behind us. Because we are aware of the fact that a lot of people got sick from the coronavirus, or my last loved ones due to the coronavirus. Just wanted to know, guys, that the ODK Book Club Nation are sending guys, ladies and gentlemen, our best wishes, and we pray for you to feel better and to have a better days and to come stronger from this challenging time. Because if anyone of the ladies and gentlemen that are supporting this channel, want to come to the podcast and be part of it and just share your message with the board, motivate the board, inspire the board, or just have a great time with me because I'm a really nice guy, please let me know in the comment below so we can arrange it. Send it, guys, have a great time, have a great day, inspire the board, have a great time with your family, friends, and neighbors. And I hope to see you all tomorrow, guys, for the next episode of the extremely, 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 extremely exciting episode of the Greatest Book Club in the World, the AK Book Club. Until then, have a great time. Take care of yourself and bye-bye. So, guys, today is Sunday, and the day today is 2 on August, 2021, and the time now is 7:58 in the evening. התאריך היום הוא השני לשמיני, 2021, השעה עכשיו היא 2:58, יום שני, מחר אנחנו עושים יום הולדת לאמא. יאללה, שברכה והצלחה, צריך להתאמן ולהמשיך הלאה. ביי.